you know, Ærious eSports, the underdog, can come back or not. Or rather not come back, but, you know, try to overthrow, bring this into a game of three, per se.
So, right now, Ærious eSports is just moving towards the top side jungle. And Impunity, all members of Impunity are moving to the mid lane. I think there will be an invade coming from the Ærious eSports and spotted out by the ward, carrying out the ward.
Yep, so we are seeing a very aggressive invade coming out from the side of AE, but here we do see an Afterburn being used. Optical goes so very low, he may just be first blood, but just look at the amount of damage that DevQ is taking as well. Ooh, let's see, Catherine going to the front lines, absorbing some sort of damage, but will be able to get away. You know,
there's actually a fight
just for the recovery, but here we see Fat Pigs go down, and that is first blood for Impunity. 2 minutes in. An aggressive invade coming out, going in and actually picking out one, maybe going for Faker. They will be, you know, be able to secure that weapon clear, and on top of that, the gold cloak as well. Here you see another aggressive invade coming out from the side of Impunity. He goes into the outer map. Ooh, and Malin will be first to go, but they are not giving up just yet. You see AE from the back lines trying to land some sort of damage, especially that of Lorelei, but Lorelei gets hunted in. Ooh, it's coming, trying to fight, but would he be needed at all? This is just overkill. You see the entirety of Impunity, they are starting to roam as a team, whereas the side of AE, not quite at this point in time. But as I'm saying that, she goes into the ultimate, secured one, and you get stunned out, but that is, it's not that bad. So Catherine, able to survive through all of that. Yeah, but now Dragon is getting captured by the side of Impunity, or rather that is just Quartivor and DevQ just trying to do it alone. But here you see Cookie Carter goes very, very low, able to land that stun, and that would be, let's see. Ooh, that would be Lorelei actually going down, and now Catherine may just be the next target. A hook will be up very, very soon, but Chingy do not care whatsoever about a hook. And will just go in, Faker's, he goes very low, one more AA. But that will not be the case, and he leaves to see another day.
So from this, we can actually see that Impunity, they are very good at the team fights, and they are playing together, and they are actually all the
trash talk being used. But this is a big moment, maybe for the side of Ærious eSports. But as I'm saying that, they go down almost immediately. Fat Pigs coming in, the Gwen, you know, quite under fun. Will he be able to do anything whatsoever? It's just so very, very pushed out in favor of Impunity, and Fat Pigs may not be able to smell this, and Glaive goes in with the AB combo and takes Gwen out.
This caused the Gwen to not know that, okay, they are coming for me, I'm gonna just go for escape, but that's not that.
Oh dear, Roasty Me Toasty goes in and tries to find a hook, and the ultimate Iron Mandate being used as well. Quartiful goes in, finds a pun, but who will survive through all of this? I mean, Malin did use the escapade, get out of it, but it's just too late. DevQ will be giving away the first kill to Ærious eSports, but that is, you know, all credits to that crystal. But you didn't see Impunity actually working already on that armory. So they have two armory in their name.
And then they can have a chance to...
Oh, there you go, there you go. The back door coming out. Impunity rushes for the crystal, and A, nowhere to be found. They are trying to CP back, but Impunity just going for the smelly place. Cookie Cutter is here, finds a stun or two, but that is just way too late. And the first game of this best of three goes over to the Impunity.
Yeah, so for the side of Ærious eSports, they have some early game heroes like Grumjaw. Kestrel is very strong early as well. So but that's not in, actually, I don't think that's actually enough to hold up their early game, because Power Spike of Kestrel doesn't really come in until she gets her items. And also, so because of the recent nerf, Celeste has reduced range. So we actually see how this plays out.
Yep. So let's see how this actually plays out. And once again, AE goes for the aggressive plays, trying to go in for that invade. Whether or not Impunity would actually spot this out is the subject altogether, but here we do see Impunity starting his fight, landing just some poke onto Cookie Carter 47, and a Gleeper Shot lands. And let's see, I mean, at this point in time, it's just poke getting exchanged. right? But a lot of melee heroes coming up from the side of AE. And all five of them, they are stuck. They're not going anywhere at all. If, once again, they are only invading to get a health turn, that would not be worth it at all. Jean goes very low, goes in, being in the front line because he may just be the first target. There's so much smoke coming out from the side of AE, and Impunity picks up first blood. Next may just be Fat Pigs, and goodbye, good night, Fakazi. You will be next, and Optical, can you actually kite this out? Can you not? And that is a double kill going over to Sky.
And like what I said earlier, is the lack of vision that actually gives away the advantage to ourselves.
You know, I often tell players last time, but oh, just look at the amount of burst coming through. And then hopefully reach the late game power spike. But I mentioned, Impunity, not quite the game, not quite the team to give you that late game, but the fight may just break out. Arden gets rooted and disposed very, very low. Chingy is as well, but Arden will be able to get away, you know. Live to see another day, but you know, honestly, at this point in time, it's better to sacrifice that Arden and then try to secure your own jungle, right? But Arden played well, you know, surviving on his own. But Kuki Carter tries to go in, tries to find something, and gets caught out of position. And he may just be the first to go down. Fountain gets popped, and Arden comes in with that gauntlet. But really, is that needed? You trap your own Doggo in, and Doggo will go down, and the next target will be that of Celeste, followed by Castro. And that is pretty much sayonara for the entire team of AE.
I don't really think it's worth it, because for Ares Esports right now, all of them are so underlevel, and as you can see, a fight breaks out and Malin gets caught, and Cordova actually is gonna be able to escape, so...
Yeah, wicked Escapade is just being so wicked right now, and on top of that, Quasiple actually able to pick that up, and as well as Lars, and Quasiple will be relentless with this chase. Price going onto the Castro. Chingy jumps in, able to pick up that off Castro. Oh, Castro actually backs away, but Quasiple goes very, very low, and Chingy with that dash, with that empowerment, will be able to pick up that of Castro, and the next target will be Faker Z, and that is the double kill for Reza, for Chingy, and they will turn their attention onto this turret. AE tries their best to try to go in, right, in that early game, try to find something, try to be aggressive. However, their team did not quite allow them to do it. Or rather, maybe it's just down to Michael. I can't say for sure. But here we see Impunity tries to take this ghost. Not this one, sorry. Black Claw, and whether or not they'll be successful, Chingy tries to go on to the Celeste. Celeste may just go down at this point in time, and Celeste will be the first to go through. Go down, definitely able to find Fat Pigs, and look at the amount of damage from those AAs. The next target will be Arden, and Arden goes down, and that is a double kill for Defqiu, and Defqiu maybe going for the triple. And that is the ace, once again, for Impunity.
So actually, Impunity just now was to actually bait out the enemy team so that the enemy team come for contest, and from what you see here, actually this is pretty much game for the side.
Yeah, I mean at this point in time, it is me trying to hide this closing out, whether or not AE can actually come back to try to defend this crystal from falling, but that would not be the case at all. I mean, good game well played to both Ares Esports and Impunity.